Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to a new episode of Eve Echoes. Tonight on the show, we're going to continue our lore series, and we're going to further expand on the Jove. If you remember, on last episode in the lore series, Bedtime Stories, we actually introduced the Jove and how they came to be in terms of recent history, and what actually do we know about them. But what's important is the early days, how the Jove came from and how they evolved into the society we know today. And most importantly, what was the Sleepers' role in all of this? Because we know the Sleepers were one of the three original ancestors of the civilizations in New Eden. So we all know that the Jove are the fifth major empire in the game. Although they're not playable, their territory is inaccessible by all but the game developers. They're a secluded, mysterious faction and the very first empire to rediscover spaceflight in New Eden. The Jove were masters of genetic modifications and created an advanced civilization that started millennia ahead of all other empires. They eventually spliced themselves so thoroughly they managed to inhibit all aggressive behavior within their species. Their hubris came at a huge cost though, and today very few Jovians remain, even maybe none at all, due to the Jovian disease, a sickness caused by oversplicing and further genetic manipulation that causes such a deep depression that the victim loses the will to live. We've covered this in the previous episode. Jove technology is many decades ahead of the other empires, and the invention of the capsule, the pod a capsulator uses to control a ship with his mind alone, is attributed to them. The Jove guard their secrets carefully. The only known way to speak directly with the Jove is by joining the Society of Conscious Thought, the most prestigious college in New Eden. So how did the Jove that we know today came to be? Well, during the first stage of New Eden settlement, the Jovians were one of the least developed groups of colonizers. Now, we're going to emphasize the initial ancestry is actually the Jove ancestry, but they're actually the Sleepers, and we'll soon figure out why. Most significantly, they lacked advanced warp drives, so they fitted their colony ships with cryogenic hibernation pods for extended journeys. Hint, hint. In their greatest effort, they sent seven such ships with 30,000 colonizers each to a distant constellation on a trip which would take them roughly 300 years. The crews of those ships were divided into two groups: the architects, designers, terraformers and builders for the new world, and the Enhedwani, a group of technicians who would take turns to care for the architects during their cryosleep on the long journey. Collectively, they were known as the Sleepers. So there you have it. This is how and why the Sleepers are called the Sleepers. They were actually the Jovian people in the early days. That's what the Sleepers are all about. One thing the Jovians slash Sleepers were good at was the development of virtual reality systems and to provide a life for the Sleepers. Keep in mind, this was before they actually started with the genetic manipulation. So they created simulations which would enable the minds of the travelers in cryostasis to interact with each other. During their long journey, the Sleepers developed their own paradigm for virtual life based on their condition. The central precept was that every participant must have been born in the physical world to enter, and for every soul inside the virtual world, there must be a body in the real one to return. So, sort of like the Matrix, but an interesting law that any creature living inside a virtual reality thingy would have to abide. In a way, the Sleepers are almost like a metaphor for the players of Eve. No bots allowed. Because the Sleepers were still en route when the Eve Gate collapsed, they survived the cataclysm. Upon awakening at their destination after centuries of travel, however, they realized that the civilization they had come from was gone. Together, the architects and Enhedwani revived their society, and so Jovians, as we know them today, are their direct descendants. So Jovians were actually the Sleepers, and the sleepers were actually Jovian, and the Jovians we know today are the direct descendants of that faction, Jovian slash sleeper. Some, however, did not simply want to rebuild the old way of life, but rather developed the VR systems even further. While the Anadwani were poised to become political leaders and the leaders of the future Jovian society, several architects created a virtual realm called the Construct, and many who had become used to a life in virtual reality joined them. With the help of the VR systems, they managed to develop and test technology in simulated realities, which they could fully control. Most significantly, they could accelerate the passage of times in those simulations, which enabled fast-paced development. That's a very interesting part of how they managed to achieve grandeurs of technology in such a short and limited time. The architects of the Construct became a technological elite, while the rest of the Jovians developed biotechnological and genetical engineering methods to advance their minds and bodies further. Eventually, the Jovian disease began to afflict the population, and despite their advanced methods, neither the architects nor any other Jovians could find a cure. Some believed that the architects had engineered the disease to forcibly convince all Jovians that the future lies in virtual existence. Regardless of whether they did so or not, the architects failed to convince the entirety of Jovian society to join them in the Construct. Ultimately, they seceded and migrated away from New Eden, until they eventually arrived in Anoikis, the system cluster which we call Wormhole Space. This is not present inside the game, but will probably available actually to the players, but will probably be available soon whenever the sleepers are introduced. We know Wormhole Space already exists in Eve Echoes. We found it. You can check out one of our previous videos. They're there. The Anadwani remained behind as Jovian society declined around them. They began to manipulate its citizens and the other societies of New Eden, eventually leading to the revelation of capsule technology to the Kaldari. In the end, the Anadwani themselves drifted away from Jovian society and vanished into obscurity. Some assume they did so intentionally to keep manipulating all the empires unnoticed. The sleepers further developed virtual reality during their second migration. This interlinked each other's minds and created systems which allowed them to remote control powerful combat vessels from within the Construct. This control interface worked similar to the capsules used by the Jovians, but without the need of physical links between ship and pilot. So they use these sleeper drones to guard their new settlement in Anoikis, which is Wormhole Space, to which we are barred from, and the same ancient machines still defend them to this day. This is yet to be developed into this timeline of Eve Echoes. We'll definitely see it soon enough. The sleepers also found out that they had not been the first to reach Anoikis. The Talokan civilization had arrived there before them, possibly originating from the New Eden constellation Ochillon, where ancient Talokan stargates were later found and studied. It is not entirely clear how the encounter between the sleepers and the Talokan played out. There are some indications that the Talokan worshipped the sleepers as exalted beings. Others assume they may have been a war in which the sleepers employed biological weapons. The most likely theory is that the Talokan and sleepers coexisted, but because the Talokan had not developed infomorph technology, they succumbed to a massive pandemic. The term infomorph refers to a virtual body of information that possesses sentience, meaning the Talokan did not find a way like to transfer their consciousness and such. So they succumbed to a massive pandemic, and while the sleepers tried to help them, they ultimately failed. At around the time the sleepers were faced with their own problems, which point to a possible explanation for almost simultaneous collapse of both Anoikis civilizations. Within the Construct, an infomorph had awakened, which possessed no physical body and therefore violated the sleepers' paradigm of one mind, one body. Either this entity, called the Other, defended itself against sleeper prosecution for being a deviant, or it proactively initiated a takeover of the construct. There are hints that the Enheduani might have planted the seeds for the awakening of the other, which is the sentient AI that basically was not abiding to the rules of the construct, during the time of the Sleeper Jovian Schism, or at least had realized that there was a potential for such an entity to emerge from the construct. In any case, the Other imprisoned the Sleepers indefinitely in their virtual reality and only used them to control the Sleeper drones. The Architect's reign over the Sleeper society was broken and the Sleepers became slaves. So this is an interesting theory on how the Sleepers came to be into wormhole space. We don't have this part yet available in Eve Echoes, but it is a very important and every interesting piece of lore that basically tells the story of the Sleepers and how they got from Terra, or the known systems, constellations, whatever, where Terrans used to live, inside New Eden, and then migrated even further into what's known as wormhole space. All in all, regarding the entity mentioned as the Other, there are a couple books that you might want to read. They're short novels, which I think would be to your delight. I'll try to put the link in the description if I manage to find them. I don't know if you can find them on Amazon or if they're available to the public. I don't want to infringe any copyright laws as pointing you to some EPUBs that are pirated or something, but I'll definitely write down the names in the description and you can Google them up and get them on your Kindle or whatever and you can read them, because they're very, very, very good written and I really enjoyed reading them a couple of years ago. So that's pretty much it on the Jove and the Sleepers. Thank you guys for watching. A very big shout out to my channel supporters. I'll see you guys next time. Cheers.